What's up, guys? Today, we're going to be looking at one of the Sentinel High Sky's recent Cash Cup games. More specifically, a high point match where he snagged the dub and propelled himself to finish third place overall. It's going to be interesting because High Sky is not really known as a solo player. Most of his success in the past has been in team-based modes. So despite all of that, you know, he still managed to do insanely well last week. So I think there's a lot we can learn from his strategies. Though I have to ask, okay, so who do you want to see analysis of the most? Alright, so we usually do players like Mongrel, Booga, Benji Fishy. Today is somebody new, and next time, who knows? It could be your favorite pro player, so let us know in the comments below. And while we're examining a pro player in this video, do you know where you can have your games analyzed? Yeah, I have a place for you. It's at ProGuys.com. Our marvelous coaches can help you guys get better by reviewing your gameplay and telling you how to fix your mistakes. Like, who does that? We do. If you're more of a practical learner, you know you can always schedule some games with them for a more one-on-one experience. So we've got all sort of stuff, okay? We got all sort of guides and video courses available to help you guys improve no matter your skill level, man. So be sure to like the video and sub to the channel. Then head on over to ProGuys.com to get started. All right, guys, this is your motivation guide. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. I am back to inspire you to be great, not only in this game, but also in life. I want to tell you right now, don't settle. Always look to improve. Always look to be better in every area of your life. Always look to be better, you know, in your family. Always look to be better in school or a job that you're working at. Always look to be better. Always look to take it to the next level. Like, you should be a different person every single month. You should be a different person every single year. So make sure to always look for ways to improve, all right? In every area of your life, people should look at you and be like, wow, you've changed so much. And they should say that to you all the time because you're constantly growing. You hear what I'm saying? Connect me on my new Insta at Your Motivation Guy. All right, guys, ladies and gentlemen, it's about that time. Everybody around the whole world, it's time to sit back, relax, and grab some of my favorite candy. You know what I'm talking about. Scream it out loud. It's that Bunch of Crunch. And let's get this going. So Sky High starts things off by landing in a somewhat remote area near the Blue Steel Bridge. He doesn't drop at a POI or a prominent landmark because he's not really too concerned about killing players and getting a crazy amount of loot, right? Well, at least not right now. There are huge risks associated with the hot drop, so this landing here, and I mean like right here, focuses more on finding shields and surviving to the end game. Because not only is there the slurp truck up ahead, you know, he could get if he wasn't contestant, but there are also some mushrooms in the woods nearby. Early game RNG can be pretty brutal, man. I get it. So High Sky is circumventing it, playing it smart, and landing safe and near shields. Now, his kit isn't really all that great. It ain't really all good. And his opponent down the hill here probably has more health and mats from the Elim they got, right? So High Sky makes the smart decision to back off and continue his looting path. He still goes for the snipe as he exits out, since there isn't really much risk in taking that. But his loadout isn't complete, and the safe zone is really far away, so he really doesn't have to pursue the kill. And this right here is why it's so great to land close to natural shields. Even though Sky High gets two big pots right here, he chooses to hold into them and eat some mushrooms instead. Shields you can find in the environment, like these mushrooms. Slurp kegs, or even the new ice freezers, right? You know, they're really viable for, you know, mitigating RNG. If you guys aren't utilizing these in your own games, do yourself a favor and reevaluate your loot paths. If you route your early game so that you pass through areas with shields, it's gonna make your matches a lot more consistent. Trust your guy, all right? All right, so when High Sky rotates to Risky, he hears some shots ring out ahead. However, he doesn't rush into the action right away. Instead, he remains patient. Even though his kit is complete, it's not the best. But also, if it was, he still would want to take fights where he has the starting advantage. Like, you know, like once he sees the metal base with a player inside, that's a scary fight to take, right? The enemy could be in any of those boxes, and the fully built metal is hard to deal with. Plus, on top of that, you know, he doesn't know who else is waiting to strike nearby. He makes the right move and dips, but then he heads back when he sees the guy hop out of his box. So that patience, guys, it really ends up paying off. And he lands a snipe on his unsuspecting target. Since the safe zone is pretty close, High Sky can push this and go for the Elim. A lot of good players apply pressure on the enemy's builds after landing an initial tag. That helps prevent them from healing up as you close the gap, right? It's just something you should always do when pushing up to finish the kill. All right, guys, so watch this fight. Take notice of how slowly High Sky proceeds. He's not afraid to stop and heal when he needs to, or even like go pick up some extra loot, as he does in this case. So High Sky knows the storm is a couple of minutes away, and he has time to spare. So he could just stop for a few seconds, right? Because despite like what you think, it's not always about finishing every fight as quickly as possible. Sometimes, you know, it's just really better to chill, you know, heal or farm mats, you know, do whatever you need to recover resources, right? And then attack when you're ready. Call playing smart. Since High Sky only has 60 mats left, he gives up the build battle and he goes into box fighting mode. So he sets up this ramp phase technique here to land a sneaky shot. It almost works. He just whiffs it, editing out once his wall is taken, using like what he has left to take high ground, which allows him to land a pump and break the guy's shield. At this point, guys, with no mats, character movement and aim become vital. You can even see him move closer to the wall to give himself a better jump shot angle. I want to say that this bit of movement here really helped him, you know, stay alive. And ultimately, the nasty shotgun flip picks up the limb. That's why, guys, you gotta work on your aim. It could be a lifesaver. Now, usually at this point, he should be looking to farm mats and move toward the center of the zone, right? But he sees some dude fishing out in the open. Hey, it's not the best time to take a fight, but, you know, if they're out in the open, you know, twiddling their thumbs, you know, reading a book, you might as well try to start something. So he goes for the shot, and look at what I mean by it just wasn't the best time. Another player rotates on a boat who would have for sure third party had Sky High been a little bit more aggressive. So it's generally too risky to take fights as players are rotating in. So our man makes the correct move and he disengages. All right, guys, so fast forwarding a little bit, look at how High Sky reacts to bumping into an enemy. His first instinct is to pickaxe swing and like signal a truce. Not because he wants to be entirely passive or anything like that. You'll see what I mean a bit more in a second. But it's more because High Sky doesn't have an immediate advantage in this fight. It didn't start with him just landing a snipe or some rifle shots. He doesn't have height, and his mats aren't where they should be, all right? Plus, on even top of that, there are still a couple of enemies behind him from before. Now, the enemy won't always accept a truce, so you still gotta be ready to spring into action. Nevertheless, in this case, he does, and it allows High Sky to avoid this unfavorable encounter. And this, guys, is what I meant by he's not trying to be completely passive. Now that he's in the safe zone and that same player is now out in the open, High Sky takes the shot and cleanly lands it to get it done. There really isn't much to say about how he landed this shot other than he used his opponent's jump to calculate where to aim. And it's a part of the reason why we try, guys, to recommend not jumping all the time. Unless, you know, you need to look around, you know, I get it. If a sniper has self-restraint, they won't shoot immediately. They'll wait for you to jump and just line up the shot with where you're landing. In this case, jumping cost the player his life. All right, guys, so moving on. Now that Sky High has an RPG, he's in zone and he's stacked on materials, he's going to hit up an upgrade bench. These things got a considerable buff recently. So upgrading your weapons now costs way, way, way less material. They were a bit iffy to use before, especially in solos, but now, you know, with the lore requirements, they're a practical and RNG-free method of obtaining higher tier loot. So just make sure you have time to farm the mats back, all right? And preferably upgrade RPGs, pump shotguns, or any like blue weapon to purple, all right? Those upgrades make the most significant leaps in stats and are the ones you definitely need to prioritize. So to close out circle number 3, High Sky heads near the center of zone and boxes up. All right, so an enemy player arrives next to him and sets up too, which leads to an exchange of shots. Okay, okay. And this little scuffle ends up attracting a lot of attention, especially on the enemy player. Now, why? Because they boxed up right in between everybody, all right? Being smack dab in the middle of these zones can really get you guys a lot of unwanted attention. Usually, it's better just to choose a spot with natural cover or height. That way, you're less likely to get focused on, right? But in this case, this guy didn't do that. He starts getting spammed. High Sky joins in, as he should, and you know what? I kind of like this move, where, you know, he pushes up to take his wall, right? Even though it's a bit unsafe. Usually, you want to stay away from players that are getting spammed. I understand why he did it here, though, as he almost does get the kill. Still, it's just plain dangerous, though, you know? And this could have ended very, very bad for High Sky, but luckily, he only gets tagged once, and the fight dies down, and the situation resets. Setting up in the center of zone proves to be useful yet again as High Sky ends up right inside the next circle. Guys, all right, you gotta pay attention to how proactive High Sky is during the zone, all right? Even though he's safe and he could have just AFK in the comfort of his own box, he's not doing that. He's opening windows and he's looking for shots and rotators because every little bit of pressure matters. And more importantly, he doesn't forget about the enemy boxed up above him. tunnel visioning or putting all your focus on a single task is really one of those things you can't do if you want to survive during endgame, all right? You always, always want to keep a mental note of where all your enemies are positioned and like what they're doing. In this case, High Sky plays it safe, making a small move here and there, you know, just to see how his opponent reacts. And they sort of just don't. Perhaps this guy was lagging out, or who knows, maybe he was tunnel vision. Either way, playing it slowly to see the response was the right move. All right, guys, so moving on to the end game, here we go. This is where you're going to see a lot of early rotations being made, all right? Anytime the safe zone is revealed, High Sky makes sure to be the first one on the move. Fast in-game rotations are very, very critical in cash cups, not only to survive, but you know, also to find frags on those that aren't as quick. If you rotate too slowly, you risk falling behind the pack and getting held in the storm. So once High Sky is safely inside, all right, there's really no real advantage to rotating any further. So he just boxes up. And I really, really like that he sets up two boxes with metal. You definitely don't want to build a wood base during the end game, guys. It's really easy to get W keyed or spam in a wooden one by one compared if it was metal or brick. And setting up two boxes, yo, that also helps a lot, as most players are not willing to push somebody that they don't have an exact position of. So if you struggle with tunnel visioning, all right, take notes on what Sky High is doing right here. And I mean right here. He never focuses on a single direction for longer than like 8 seconds. He's always checking his surroundings, especially if he hears someone approaching. Now, this extension outward is a bit too aggressive and really doesn't pay off, but High Sky is quick to realize that, all right? He's saying something on the lines of, I'm looking for a kill when I don't need one. And you know what? He was totally right. Typically, like, the only time you want to forego positioning and play aggressively during an endgame is if you need an impact frag. That's when you're low on materials or, you know, other resources and you don't really think you're going to survive unless you get an LM. You really have no choice, so you got to do it. But in this case, his resources are pretty good. So, you know, he's correct. He shouldn't be taking the risk. So the next zone's revealed to head back in the direction High Sky came from, right? One tip I could give you guys for when zones pull back to previous areas is to try and think of what you left behind, all right? In this case, High Sky remembers his old metal base, the one where he got a kill, and there was some wood he left behind there. So just because he recalled that bit of info, yo, he's up to 200 wood he wouldn't otherwise have. And at this point, there's only a bit of wood left in High Sky's inventory. So, you know, he's going to need an impact frag. So he goes to pressure the person closest to him. Again, it's a player tunnel visioning super hard. And I want to point out this technique he does right here, right? I want you to look at this. Look at how preemptively he sets up a second box. You know, it's sort of becoming like a go-to technique now, you know, to connect two boxes before pressuring someone's wall. The whole point is to really give you guys room to fall back in case your pieces get taken, right? Rather than being stuck. So I know it doesn't come into play here, but I thought you might like to know why he did it, right? Once he picks up all the spoils from the kill, High Sky goes back to rotating. He doesn't even stop to look for a lens because, again, it's super essential to rotate quickly and just really try to stick as close to the next safe zone as possible. Once he gets there, you know, that's when he can look back and focus on the lens. This time, he's rocketing the players on high ground. Taking high during these very last moments of the match is one of the best ways to close out a game. Why? Okay, let me tell you why. Because enemies likely are not going to have the mass to contest you. That and the circle is sometimes so small that they won't even be able to. So I presume that's why he's focusing high ground, so he can take it later. In the meantime, he gets shot out, but it's really not a big deal. The fall only scrapes his knee. He's pretty much only RPG spamming right here, but that's what he needs to be doing. Because it's so effective at clearing out high ground, someone falls and even gets him in a limb. And when he sees that, that's the moment he goes for height and look. Bam! Free kill. Man, I didn't expect that. Rockets from high ground are tough to block, so he sends one out and boom! Another easy one. Now things get scary when the last remaining player knocks him down. But with the force of the golden rocket launcher in his hands, High Sky sends the enemy falling right to his grasp. So, everybody, I think, you know, there's one thing that we can all take away from High Sky's game here. It's the power of patience, to be real. You know, in numerous cases throughout this match, his decision to just slow down and take his time, it really, really helped him out. You know, from the very, very beginning, his willingness to drop remotely and near natural shields helped him gain a health and advantage he otherwise wouldn't have had. Anytime High Sky was playing aggressively, it was because he had an advantage in the fight. And if he didn't, he'd back off and he'd just wait for the right moment. You know, in some fights, he wasn't afraid to completely reset or just disengage because sometimes it's just better to box up and heal instead of just trying to finish the battle ASAP. Rather than looking for action during the mid-game, you know, he played it safe by just upgrading his weapons and farming resources. Something most of us need to do a lot more often. And during the late game, High Sky was always looking at his surroundings. He was playing smart. You know, one small slip up can really spell the end of your game right here. So, you know, you can't tunnel vision. You have to be aware. And one last thing, you know, by rotating quickly and timing his high ground, you know, at the end, he mopped up the remaining players and he just picked up the win. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed this video. Once again, this is your motivation guide. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. Listen. Connect with me on my new Insta. Want to hear from you guys. I believe in you. Don't give up. Don't surrender. Be successful, not only in this game, but also in life. You're going to do it, man. Anyway, thanks so much. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, please be sure to click the thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. And remember to leave a comment on who you want to see us analyze next. Also, you can use code ProGuys in the item shop if you'd like to support us even further. All right, guys, we'll see you next time.